The truth is out there. The truth is out there. The truth.
On answers!
I want the truth! You can't handle the truth!
Nope. And neither can the 100,000 odd people who RSVP'd the Storm Area 51 invite, drug their asses all the way out to the deserty bumfuck nowhere, and then you're all pussied out after the set list of the first band that played. Burn. Am I right? Huh? Huh? There's no more meme, you know. That's it. That's all I could come up with. Jack Nicholson screaming in one of his many iconic roles. I got nothing else. Roll the clip. Hello, hello. Welcome one and all. And ladies and gents, let's give a big hand to world's greatest actor, Jack Nicholson. He probably wouldn't approve of me using his greatest scene in this fashion, but then again, he doesn't likely know who the hell I am, so who cares? And with that, let's move on to this episode's news commentary. Today, we are reviewing the Area 51 raid. People gathered near U.S. military base to see them aliens. Photographers said it was unclear if arrests were made as crowd gathered at 3 a.m. Friday in response to hoax to raid the base. Well, I don't know about you folks, but I'm not quite sure it was a hoax to everybody. I'm pretty sure they just couldn't elect someone to go and get shot first. You do it. Nah, man, you do it. No, man, you do it. Yeah, let's flip a coin. Hey, you know, I hear Floater and freaking and Fish were playing. Let's go back and let's go have a drink and man, then you're doing it. No, man, you do it. And me, I just love the sign that is being held by that woman in the first photograph of the news piece. A woman carries a sign outside a gate to Area 51 in Rachel, Nevada on Friday, and it says, "Locked up for what?" Locked up for what? I don't know. Maybe has anyone ever considered, or I would invite them to please consider, the other logical reasons why, if aliens were being held at Area 51, why they would not only being kept secret, but being locked up. Like, did anyone see the scenes from Independence Day? Release me. Has anyone considered that after getting dissected, said alien that was caught might be a little pissed off and signaling to his comrades, his buddies, his collective, that we're gonna annihilate the fuck out of these assholes, like that are cutting to me like I'm a fucking fish or a frog in a high school project? Or maybe you know, they were already bent on world domination and we just got to them, and that by keeping them, they can't signal to their comrades up there in outer space to come annihilate the fuck out of us. I don't know. There's one of many reasons why humanitarians like this young lady right here, this young hippie philanthropist who isn't wearing a tinfoil hat, might want to keep the aliens locked up if said aliens were there. Just saying, folks. Just saying. I know you want to be all peace and love here, but maybe they don't if they are in Area 51, if they are out there, if the truth is out there. About 75 people arrived early on Friday at a gate at the once secret Area 51 military base in Nevada, at the time appointed by an internet hoster to storm the facility to see space aliens, and at least two were detained by sheriff's deputies. Wow, only 75 people. Less than, what, 0.0001% or something that could collectively come up with the balls to even think about storming the gate? Like, they just came to the gate to get selfies? You know, I mean, Jesus Christ, people, like, out of 100,000, there wasn't enough. Well, at least, actually, on a good point, there's at least 100,000 people that were just looking for a good time, that were probably not going to storm the facility, that actually took it as a hoax and didn't take it seriously, and then 75 people out of that 100,000, or whatever, I think it says 150 later on in the article, that came to the gates, that walked all the way to the Area 51 gates, at least just that many dumb enough people who didn't get themselves shot and removed from the human gene pool showed up. So good numbers there, good numbers. Like, there's still sane people out there that were just looking for a good time, you know, looking to go to alien stock, see some bands play, and take some selfies maybe. Like, that's good. That is really good. I applaud all those intelligent people who had the money to go waste after they probably already went to Burning Man. Like, I'm glad to see that. Like, I'm very happy to see that, actually. The Storm Area 51 invitation spawned festivals in the tiny Nevada towns of Rachel and Hyco nearest the military site, and a more than two-hour drive from Las Vegas. The Lincoln County Sheriff, Kerry Lee, estimated late Thursday that about 1,500 people had gathered at the festival sites and said more than 150 people also made the rugged trip several additional miles on bone-rattling dirt roads to get within selfie distance of the gates. My apologies. I think like over 150,000 people RSVP'd to that, but only 1,500 people showed up. So in good respects, at least that many people showed up that were sane, 150,000 people who were, you know, probably just thought it was a joke and just RSVP scared the living shit out of the government. I'm sure they probably did take this as a threat, guys. Remember that. Like, that's a lot of dissent in the ranks for the government. You know, one more excuse for them to fire up them FEMA camps. And also, in light of all this, in respect to this is actually good for those towns. I mean, they probably got, like, their entire year's revenue of tourist Dean just from this one event, so that's also a good thing to note. Like, these two tiny towns that are a tourist attraction for all the UFO sighters out there, like, they got their year's revenue probably on this one event, like, combined. That's pretty fucking awesome. An Associated Press photographer said it wasn't immediately clear if a woman who began ducking under a gate and a man who urinated, way to go, guys, like I said, like, that 75 people that almost got themselves removed from the gene pool, were arrested after the crowd gathered at about 3 a.m. on Friday. Millions of people had responded to a June internet post calling for people to run into the remote U.S. Air Force test site that has long been the focus of UFO conspiracy theories. "They can't stop all of us," the post joked. "Let's see them aliens." The military responded with stern warnings that lethal force could be used if people entered the Nevada test and training range, and local and state officials said arrests would be made if people tried. "It's public land," the sheriff said. "They're allowed to go to the gate as long as they don't cross the boundary." At least, all right, so they had backup too. The county sheriff didn't want to see any bloodshed of innocent, dumbass people trying to cross the gates. And I have also seen videos before of people going to the boundary lines on other ends of the test site only to be met with, like, government officials, strangely dressed, actually, like, pushing, shoving them back and be like, "Get the fuck out of here, guys. Get the fuck out of here." So take that seriously, folks, the next time you do this. It's all good fun until someone gets their ass removed from the gene pool. A music group called Wiley Savage erected a stage on Thursday near the Little Alien in Rachel and began playing after dark for several hundred campers who braved overnight temperatures at about 45 degrees Fahrenheit, 7 degrees Celsius. The music kicked off weekend events inspired by an internet hoax to see them aliens that the Lincoln County Sheriff Kerry Lee said had drawn perhaps 1,500 people to the two tiny desert towns. Lee said late on Thursday that more than 150 people also made the rugged trip on washboard dirt roads to get within selfie distance of two gates to the Area 51 U.S. Air Force installation that has long fueled speculation about government studies of space aliens and UFOs. The Air Force has issued stern warnings for people not to try and enter the Nevada test and training range where Area 51 is located. Lee said no arrests were made. "It's public land," the sheriff said. "They're allowed to go to the gate as long as they don't cross the boundary." We've already gone over this. Authorities reported no serious incidents so far in Rachel and Hyco, the two towns closest to Area 51 on a road dubbed the Extraterrestrial Highway 2 hours from Las Vegas. Earlier in Rachel, Wiley Savage guitarist Alan Burton said he saw a chance to perform for people who, like Martinez, were looking for a scene in which to be seen. "It started as a joke, but it's not a joke for us," he said. "We know people will come out, we just don't know how many." Michael Ian Boer, a University of Nevada Las Vegas sociologist who researches pop culture and paranormal activity, called the event a perfect blend of interest in aliens and the supernatural, government conspiracies, and the desire to know what we don't know. The result, Boer said, was hope and fear for events that include the Area 51 base camp, featuring music, speakers, and movies in Hyco, and festivals in Rachel and Las Vegas competing for the name Alien Stock. "People desire to be part of something, to be ahead of the curve," Boer said. "Area 51 is a place where normal, ordinary citizens can't go. When you tell people they can't do something, they just want to do it more." Great. A place in the country where adult human beings can go act like 12-year-olds. Don't do drugs or have sex, young Billy. "Why, Dad?" "Because you'll get shot by government officials if you do so." "Oh, See, that's, I mean, honestly, that's the best analogy I can make to this, is like, this is a place where tourists, adult human beings, can go and act like 12-year-olds and play chicken with government officials who will likely shoot your ass dead if you stick one foot past the boundary line. And one of these days, folks, it is going to happen. This is just the beginning. Eric Holt, the Lincoln County Emergency Manager overseeing preparations, said he believed authorities could handle a total of 30,000 visitors to Rachel and Heiko. Still, neighbors braced for trouble after millions of people responded to the Storm Area 51 Facebook post weeks ago. Those that know what to expect camping in the desert are going to have a good time, said Jorg, our new Rachel resident who can see the festival grounds from his home. Those who show up in shorts and flip-flops will find no protections from or against critters, snakes, and scorpions. It's going to get cold at night, they're not going to find what they're looking for, and they're going to get angry, Arnu said, while the rest of us who are either RSVP'd and stayed home or just watched from our computer screens laugh our asses off. Good on you, Facebook. Good on you, social media. You did it again. You gave me content to talk about. You gave content for people to laugh about, etc., etc. Thank you very much. Well, I hope you all liked this rather lighthearted and pointless vid. All joking aside, please don't storm and or get shot at any government fortresses. And please remember to like, comment, and subscribe to this video, and to drop me a line if you have a request for a video to be done. Thank you very much for joining. This has been your host, Raynard C. Fox, and remember, live long and prosper. Nah, I'm just kidding, folks. Well, not about the live long and prosper part. Duo nunquam desiste, da nunquam continuo unam duas ve uncias. Never give an inch and never give up. Unless you're one of those Area 51 folks trying to get past the gates and get shot. Yeah, you should probably give in and you should give up before you get to the gates. And seriously, unless you want to remove yourself from the gene pool, live long and prosper. But also, you know, never give an inch. Ah, you folks know what I mean. Have a good night. Thank you very much for listening, and we'll make more videos for you folks soon. Goodbye.